Hello everyone, and welcome to today's webinar, Methods to Advance Your CAR-T and CAR-NK Cell Research. I am Michelle Ashton of Labroots, and I'll be your moderator for today's event. Today's educational web seminar is presented by Labroots and brought to you by Miltenyi Biotech. To learn more, visit miltenybiotech.com. We encourage you to participate today by submitting any questions you may have during this presentation. To do so, simply type them into the Ask a Question box and click Send. We'll answer as many questions as we have time for at the end of the presentation. You may also submit any technical issues here as well if you have trouble seeing or hearing the presentation. This webinar is educational and thus offers free continuing education credits. Please click on the Continuing Education window at the bottom of your screen to obtain your credits. I'd like to now welcome our speakers, Dr. Saskia Roche, Global Product Manager for T-Cell Immunology at Miltenyi Biotech, and Dr. Julia Hengst, Global Product Manager for NK Cell Immunology at Miltenyi Biotech. Welcome, you may now begin your presentation.
Yeah, thank you very much for having us. My name is Saskia and I say welcome everybody to our today's webinar focusing on CAR-T and CAR-NK cell research solutions. Within the next 40 minutes, you will learn about Miltenyi Biotech's CAR-T and CAR-NK cell research solutions from cell enrichment, expansion, up to final functionality analysis. For deeper and more extensive information, please visit our website and of course, always reach out to your local sales organization for demos, quotes, and additional information. Let's have a brief look at our today's agenda. After some information about our company, we will start off with an introduction into the topic cell and gene therapy. Then Julia will share tips and tricks about different T and NK cell isolation approaches and their benefits. Afterwards, we will explain how to optimize your cell culture conditions. And finally, we will also touch different cell analysis solutions with focus on flow cytometry. Miltenyi, who is still the owner of our company, developed the MUX technology, a column-based magnetic cell isolation technique already in 1990. Already 25 years ago, we started to develop our clinical portfolio, and by now about 6,000 patients are treated each year with cells isolated with our trusted and well-established MUX technology. What started as a one-man's diploma thesis has since then grown into a global company of more than 3,500 employees worldwide, with almost a quarter of all employees working in R&D, engineering, and clinical development. And we have over 46,000 scientific publications citing our MUX technology. And we all work together to advance scientific research and medicine by providing solutions for curative cell and gene therapy as well as biomedical research. The specialty of Miltenyi Biotech is a combination of pioneering solutions and integrated workflow, meaning that we do not only offer devices, reagents, and consumables, but also R&D expertise and support throughout the whole workflow. All our products are tested and used in our in-house R&D within special applications. And two of those applications are the CAR-T and CAR-NK cells, our today's topic. Now we will start with a short introduction into cell and gene therapy. Research for cancer therapy, for those of you that are quite new in the field. Thanks to the effort of thousands of PhD students, scientists, and physicians, CAR-T cell therapy has achieved fantastic success, especially with CD19 targeted CAR-T cell therapeutics for hematological malignancies. However, many challenges remain, such as side effects, poor penetration of the tumor mass, and limited tumor cell killing due to an immunosuppressive microenvironment of solid tumors. To address such limitations and advance the field, a lot of research is going on at present. The development and optimization of those living drugs includes the identification of novel targets, identification of the best starting cell subsets, improvement of safety, specificity, and efficacy, the verification of novel targets on several animal models. Moreover, it's important to optimize the manufacturing process and establish a reliable IPC and QC right from the start. Developing and optimizing CAR T-cell immune therapeutic goes back and forth from benchtop research to early clinical development. Therefore, it is important to follow a workflow that enables you to switch between a research and a clinical setting. Both cell types, T-cells as well as NK cells, can be used or are used for cell and gene therapy. The T-cells belong to the adaptive immune system, whereas the NK cells belong to the innate immune system. The major difference is that T-cells are activated via antigen priming, whereas for NK cells, no antigen priming is required. And the T cells, they recognize their targets through the T cell receptor, whereby the NK cells recognize the targets through a complex array of NK cell receptors. Now we'll take a closer look into the different engineering procedures. Basically, we have two options, the autologous and the allogenic approach. The autologous approach depicted on this slide includes the same steps no matter if you start with T cells or NK cells. For the autologous approach, T cells or NK cells are taken from a cancer patient, genetically modified to express the CAR. Using viral transduction or electroporation, and then the engineered T cells are expanded ex vivo and finally reinfused into the same patients. However, for CAR and NK cells, the allogenic approach is more common. But why is it more common? Because it's easier, as there's no need for further modifications. You simply isolate NK cells derived from any healthy donor and follow the same workflow as for the autologous approach described before. The only difference is that the final NK cell product is infused into any suitable cancer patient. In comparison to the allogenic approach for NK cells, for T cells, there is a need to knock out the endogenous T cell receptor. Independent of the approach, we at Miltenyi Biotech offer solutions to generate both engineered T and NK cells. You will always start off with blood products, like whole blood, leukopak, buffer coat, or LSC to isolate your T cells or NK cells. Next, the cell populations will be activated and transduced. After a successful gene delivery, cells will be expanded in dedicated media and cytokine cocktails. And at the very end of the workflow, you will have a look at the functionality by flow cytometric analysis.
Hey, I'm Julia. And also warm welcome from my side. I'm going to take over the next part. So let's start with the first step of the workflow, which is the enrichment of T cells or NK cells from blood products. Looking at the T and NK cell isolation in more detail, you can either isolate them by positive isolation, meaning that the T or NK cells are magnetically enriched with either CD4 and CD8 microbeads or with CD56 microbeads. On the other hand, T or NK cells can also be isolated in an untouched manner, meaning that all other cells are labeled with microbeads and depleted. Here we basically have two options. The first option is to isolate our T cells or NK cells from PBMCs. So for the T cells, we recommend to use the 1-to-1 mixture of CD4 and CD8 microbeads for positive isolation, or our T-cell isolation kit for untouched isolation. The microbeads and kits are available for many, many different T-cell subtypes, for example, to isolate PAN T-cells, naive T-cells, T-Rex, and so on. For NK cells, however, we recommend to use a two-step separation based on a T-cell depletion with CD3 microbeads, followed by an NK cell enrichment with CD56 microbeads. In case the NK cells should be isolated in an untouched manner, the NK cell isolation kit is recommended. The second option is to isolate your cells of interest directly from various blood products. This is quite new and very straightforward approach. Using the straight form approach, you can completely skip the time-consuming density gradient centrifugation and isolate, for example, CD4, CD8 T cells from a buffy coat within only 30 minutes. Either with positive isolation with a straight form microbeads for T cells or NK cells, or with an untouched approach using the Max Express kits for the NK cells. With both approaches, you can completely skip the density gradient centrifugation and isolate NK cells from a buffy coat within only 30 minutes. However, independent of the approach you decide for, the basis is always MUX technology. But why is it so beneficial to use MUX technology for immune cell manufacturing? Our technology is based on the MUX columns. Through the columns, the magnetic field is amplified by 10,000 fold. This allows us to reduce the number of beads for enrichment and leads to minimal labeling of the cells. Further, there is a large space between the steel spheres of the column matrix that enables a free flow through of non-labeled cells and enrichment of minimal labeled cells without unspecific cell activation. If you have a look at the electron microscopy images comparing a column-free system and ours, you clearly see the bead aggregates and the cell surface if you use a column-free system, depicted in this image here. Whereas cells isolated with the MUX technology look very natural. Taking all these benefits into account, it becomes clear why our column-based technology is used in clinical cell therapy trials worldwide. Besides the electron microscopy images, we also did some Western blot analysis and checked for upregulation of activation markers during the separation procedure of T cells. Also here, we compared column-free system with our technology. The MUX technology you can see marked with the pink borders compared to the column-free system. And as you can clearly see in comparison to this, there's no T cell activation with the T cells that were isolated with our column-based MUX technology, independent whether positive or negative selection was used. As you can see here on the left-hand side, the positive and here the negative. And here an example comparing positive and an untouched isolation approach for NK cells. So in the upper row, you can see the NK cells isolated directly from buffy coat with a straight from CD56 microbeads. And in the lower row, you can see NK cells isolated from PBMCs with the NK cell isolation kit in an untouched manner. Probably the usual NK cell isolation you know from Wilson Biotech. When using the untouched isolation, you have a very pure NK cell population, which you can see here. That is not activated. And here I'm showing the two activation markers CD25 and CD69. But if you are using the CD56 microbeads, of course you have a mixture of NK cells and NK T cells. Dependent of your project, it could also be that this is okay. However, what I would like to highlight here is that there's no difference in the expression of CD25 and CD69 on the NK cells if you are doing the untouched compared to the positive approach. So just keep in mind that when you are using the straight from microbeads, you are saving time as you can skip washes and performing FICOL, and your purity and recovery is similar or even compared to doing a density gradient centrifugation. Now, after the general MUX technology benefits, I would like to show data why T and NK cell enrichment is important in the context of engineering these cells. First of all, it is important to reduce contaminating cells, such as granulocytes, monocytes, and B cells. And with regards to NK cells, it is very important to reduce the amount of T cells. Second, we need sufficient frequencies of T or NK cells to ensure T or NK cell activation and expansion. But now let's have a closer look at the separation data. First of all, regarding the T cells, we assessed the immune cell composition using a predefined antibody panel before and after T cell enrichment. You can see these three numbers for different donors here in the bar charts. These graphs nicely show the heterogeneity in cell composition in the starting material between the donors. This would be even more obvious if we use patient material. However, after enrichment, the amount of CD4 and CD8 T cells between the different donors was similar, meaning that we started with comparable, more homogeneous samples. Additionally, we observed a correlation between the number of monocytes in the starting material and the transduction efficiency, as shown in the figure on the right-hand side, leading to the conclusion that pre-enrichment is also beneficial for the transduction efficiency. And regarding the NK cells, you can see here in the first plot whole PBMCs, then CD3 depleted, and finally CD3 depleted and CD56 enriched NK cells. Here it is important to ensure efficient CD3 depletion, especially when thinking about translation into the clinical setting, and also a sufficient enrichment of NK cells, as only approximately 10% of the PBMCs are NK cells. So now I will continue with the chapter for NK and T-cell culture and expansion. First of all, there are optimally formulated cell-specific cell culture media, namely the Tex-Mex medium and the NK-Max medium, that you can see here on the left-hand side. In addition, for those of you that are interested in iPSC-derived NK cells, we offer a medium named iPSBlue to allow for optimal cell culture of induced pluripotent stem cells. Furthermore, we have premium-grade cytokines that allow exact dosing as they have lot-specific activity. This is important for TNNK cell activation and also as trigger for expansion and differentiation. And finally, here under stimulation reagents, we have the T-cell transect that can be used for polyclonal stimulation of your T-cells via CD3, CD28 receptor engagement. It is dosed volumetrically to the T-cell culture and can be removed by a simple washing without any additional chemicals or bead removal steps that may cause additional stress and loss of cells. The next step of our workflow is a reliable activation of human T-cells. This is important for first, a successful transduction, and second, for an efficient expansion of the gene-engineered T-cells. Especially for GMP manufacturing of CAR T-cells, we developed an innovative T-cell activation reagent called T-cell transect. It is a polymeric nanomatrix that efficiently and reliably activates T-cells via CD3, CD28 engagement. Being a nanomatrix, transect is suitable also for GMP manufacturing processes. This is extremely important if you aim to translate your workflow into the clinical setting later on. Already 24 hours after addition of T-cell transect, we observe typical clusters, typical cluster formation indicative for T-cell activation. And after 48 hours, T-cell activation was verified by flow cytometry. As shown in this figure, the activation markers CD25 and CD69 were found to be upregulated, and up to 80% of the T-cell population expressed both markers afterwards. This graph here shows the comparison of T-cell expansion after stimulation with T-cell transect and Tex-Mex medium or a bead-based competitor product and RPMI, and that it was identical. Both media were supplemented with human IL-2 premium grade. We observed comparable expansion rates, but to highlight, our Tex-Mex in combination with the transect enables expansion under serum-free conditions. After the successful transduction, the T-cells need to be expanded. Having the translation into the clinical setting in mind, a serum-free system is advantageous as sourcing large amounts of abeserum is difficult. The Tex-Mex medium is therefore also available as GMP grade and thus enables clinical grade CAR T-cell manufacturing and good clinical grade T-cell expansion. As depicted here, various starting materials from healthy donors, different patients and even frozen samples can be used without affecting the cell counts, expansion rate nor the viability. Also, for the frozen patient material, we observed high viability and expansion rates following this workflow and cultivation with our serum-free medium. Now, in addition to the T-cells, we are looking at the culture and activation of NK cells, which is key for CAR NK cell engineering. Similar to the T-cells, the NK cells need to get activated before any genetic material can get put into them. For this, we have developed our NK-Max medium, And together with our MAX premium grade cytokines, in this case IL-1 beta, IL-2 and IL-15, you have a perfect system to activate your NK cells and to enable sufficient transduction. After the transduction, the CAR NK cells, similar to the conventional NK cells, are expanded in our NK-MAX medium, supplemented with IL-2 and IL-15. The plot here shows the NK expansion either with our NK-MAX medium in comparison to TexMAX and to competitor media. You can clearly see that the NK cells expand more sufficiently in the NK-MAX medium. Now, also in addition to this, you have a good activation and expansion. You can see that here in the second plot, the NK cells after cultivation for 14 days in the medium have preserved the cytotoxic function and perform well target cell killing. Here you can see the target cell killing comparing both the research as well as the GMP media. And now, looking specifically at CAR NK cells, and not only NK cells, we can show that also the engineered NK cells grow nicely in our NK-MAX media in combination with IL-2 and IL-15. What I would like to mention here is that one important aspect to have in mind, in case you culture engineered NK cells, where you reach a transduction rate of only 50%, a superior expansion is very important and even more beneficial, as you in the end also have more transduced cells that expand. So really keep in mind that good expansion of your engineered NK cells is important to have the cell numbers that you want to reach. Just here a summary slide on the NK-MAX medium. So if you haven't heard of it, check out these papers. All except two of them use the NK-MAX medium to culture CAR NK cells. So definitely have a look at it. Now the next point after activation and expansion I want to focus on is the transduction. So how do you get your gene of interest into your cells? We have developed Vectorfusin 1. Which is a viral transduction enhancer that helps you to get more virus into your cells. It is completely synthetic, non-toxic, and soluble peptable. Forget about coating plates with retronectin or anything like that. You can just mix your virus with a Vectorfusin and then add it to your cell suspension. And of course, all other reagents, and of course, as all other reagents, Vectorfusin 1 is available in research and clinical grade. So, looking at the T cells, we optimize the transduction efficiency by examining the optimal day for lentiviral transduction. Activated T cells were transduced on day 0, 1, 2, 3 after application of T cell transect. Optimal lentiviral transduction efficiency is obtained 1 day after polyclonal stimulation with T cell transect, as you can see here. In addition, as shown here on the right-hand side, after application of Vectorfusin 1, that we described already on the slide before, we were also able to enhance the transduction efficiency both in the small scale and in the automated large scale setting in the Clinimax Prodigy from roughly 26 to 41 or 44 to 70%. Now looking at the NK cells, you can see here also the viral transduction efficiency. Here you have the negative control that the NK cells that were not transduced with vector only or with vector in combination with Vectorfusin. And also here you can nicely see that there's an increase from 20 up to 80 to 90% of transduction efficiency, both for an NK cell line as well as primary human NK cells.
Hello again, it's me, Saskia, and I will now introduce our flow cytometric analysis tools for phenotypic and functional characterization of CAR T and CAR NK cells to you. As a final step of the whole engineering process, several in vitro potency assays needs to be performed. Therefore, we developed several kits as well as protocols and panels to improve the reliability and reproducibility of your assays. But what exactly is meant by a potency assays? How can you assess the potency of your engineered cells? Basically, we talk about co-culture assays of T or NK cells expressing a CAR construct and those that don't. Culture together with respective target cells, either expressing the respective target antigen or control cells that don't express the antigen. As a readout, you can have a look at the target cell killing, or you can also have a look at the T cells, analyzing their fitness and intracellular cytokine expression, and we can also have a look at secreted cytokines. For this teaser webinar here, I am not going into detail. If you're interested in the different assays for CAR-T, please have a look at the webinar linked in the presentation. Let's have a closer look at the CAR-T or CAR-NK mediated cytotoxicity. This is assessed by a killing assay. You will need a target cell line that expresses a specific antigen of interest and antigen negative cells. Engineered cells and mock transduced cells were suspended in medium and seeded in different doses into a 69 well plate. Afterwards, the target cells, antigen expressing or antigen negative, were added and incubated at 37 degrees and then acquired by the MaxQuant analyzer and analyzed using special express modes. As shown on the left-hand side, for our CAR and NK cells, we observed antigen-specific killing of the tumor cell line, as shown in the upper row. As shown on the figure on the right-hand side, CD20-directed CAR T cells are able to kill the CD20-positive target cells at an effector-to-target cell ratio of 1:1 of about 40% of the CAR target cells were killed. Another assay I would like to introduce now to you is to assess the amount of secreted cytokines in the supernatant of this co-culture assay. Here, Miltenyi Biotech offers a flow analysis kit for multi-parameter analysis of cytokines, the so-called MaxPlex multiplex assays, and they are designed for determining concentrations of up to 12 human soluble analytes on a single sample. And the analysis is based on the MaxPlex capture beads, which display defined fluorescence properties and can be identified using any multicolor standard flow cytometer. In combination with the express modes of the MaxQuant analyzers, however, the MaxPlex cytokine kits are optimized for automated measurement and simplify the flow cytometric analysis via predefined experiment settings as well as acquisition and analysis templates. So no special instruments is needed for this. It can be done on every flow cytometer and it's a real multiplexing assay. To detect CAR-T or CAR-NK mediated cytokine secretion, especially for the NK cells, it's necessary to have a target cell line that is robust against killing by NK cells and that expresses the specific antigen of interest. You co-culture then the CAR-T or CAR-NK cells with your label target cells, antigen positive and or antigen negative, you incubate them at 37 degrees, and then you use 50 microliter of the supernatant of this co-culture, and you can analyze up to 12 cytokines analytes per sample. And the flow cytometric analysis is not done by an ELISA reader, it can be simply done by any flow cytometer using the MaxPlex kit. Let's take a look at some exemplary data. Here for the CAR-T cells, we co-cultured CD20-positive target cells, in this example RhJ cells, with our CD20-directed CAR-T cells and measured the secretion of 7 different cytokines. As shown here, upon direct contact with the target cells, the CD20-directed CAR-T cells secrete high amounts of effector cytokines like interferon gamma, IL-2, or TNF-alpha, which verifies their functionality. On the right-hand side, you can see the results for the CAR-NK cells. By this assay, we were able to evaluate the functionality and antigen-specific killing of the generated CAR-T or CAR-NK cells with our MaxPlex assay. to improve the reliability and reproducibility of your in-process control and also of your quality control in the end of the workflow and speed up the whole CAR T-cell analytics, we developed several flow solutions to make your life easier. Here we offer our ReAffinity antibodies within expert antibody panels. We offer our CAR detection reagent for several to detect several CAR T-cells and enumerate them. We also offer potency assays, as mentioned before, for example, the MaxPlex cytokine kits, viability flexible dyes, annexine 5 staining kits, 7AAD staining solutions, as well as the rapid cytokine inspector combining extracellular and intracellular staining. And of course, we also offer the MaxQuantify software and the Express Mode package for user, for automated and user-independent data analysis. Yeah, and this leads me now to the last point of our today's webinar, the summary and resources. We will start with a summary of the CAR T-cell workflow. And yeah, this workflow can be separated basically in five steps. We start off with the with the cell separation or the enrichment of T cells. Here we use a mixture of CD4 and CD8 positive T cells. You can either use our microbeads or also the straight from microbeads. The next step in the workflow is a stimulation via CD3 and CD28 receptor. It's a polyclonal stimulation that enhances their transduction efficiency as well as maximizes their the expansion, and therefore we have the product T-cell transact. For the transduction, we can recommend the Vectofusin 1 transduction enhancer. And for the expansion, we offer our serum-free Tex-Mex medium, as well as our Max cytokines, where we always offer for the premium grade cytokines a certificate of analysis to guarantee unique specific dosing. And yeah, last but not least, we also introduced our flow solutions like our ReAffinity antibodies and different flow kits. We compiled different resources for CAR T-cell research for you, for example, our brochures regarding T-cell transact, and also a CAR T research brochure summarizing all of the products that can make your life easier or will make your life easier in your CAR T-cell research. We also have different application notes and customer reports available. We have a very nice R&D protocol that shows you step by step, including all the reagent, all the steps, incubation times, how to generate, how to engineer CAR T cells for research use. We also have a lot of scientific posters and publications and more detailed webinar about the different assays. To sum up the CAR and K-cell workflow, this workflow is also separated into five steps. Starting off with the separation of NK cells from blood products using the depletion of CD3 positive T cells and subsequent enrichment of NK cells for highest purity. The second step is the NK cell activation using NKmax medium in combination with cytokines followed by a transduction. And in addition, as third step, the reagents are used for CAR NK expansion. For the IPC, for the in-process control and quality control, and to improve the functionality and cytotoxicity of our CAR NK cells, we developed a CAR NK analytics portfolio, including ReAffinity recombinant antibodies, predefined antibody panels, dedicated flow analysis kit, and the matching MaxQuant Express modes and MaxQuant analyzers. And comparable to the CAR T cells, here for CAR NK cells and also NK cell research, we also have different marketing material like brochures, and we also have application notes and customer reports, as well as an application protocol and different scientific posters from our R&D. If you need more detailed information or you wish for direct support or special offers, please always reach out to your local sales representative and talk to them. Moreover, all the information about the workflows and product can be found on our website miltinibiotech.com/CAR-T-cells or CAR-NK-cells. Before we end this presentation, this webinar, please acknowledge the displayed disclaimer. And with this nice picture of our headquarter campus in Bergisch Gladbach, Germany, I would like to thank you for your attention, and now we are happy to take your questions.
Thank you so much. So now let's get started with the Q&A session. And here's also the first question. You mentioned Reaffinity antibodies. What does this stand for? And also, why are these special antibodies?
So yeah, our Reaffinity antibodies, they are really special. However, they are also like conventional antibodies with special features. They can be used for any standard flow cytometric analysis like your old antibodies. And their special features include that they have a high lot-to-lot consistency as they are recombinantly generated. And as they have a mutated Fc part, there is no FcR blocking needed. And there is a reduced background staining, so this is independent of the fluorochromes. And all Reaffinity antibodies have a universal IgG isotype control, and by this, this reduces the amount of isotype controls that is needed for the experiment and thereby reduces the experiment planning time. Let's see for the next questions here. The clinical process will be fully automated with the Prodigy. Do you also offer automation for the research part?
Yeah, so I will take this question. It is possible to do the cell separation with either the Automax or the Multimax Cell24. These instruments enable either fully automated or semi-automated cell separation. Automated in this case, with regards to the Automax, means that it allows pipetting and incubation of the sample with the magnetic microbeads, and then does also perform the separation via the column, completely user independent and automated. Whereas the Multimax 24 is doing semi-automated separation where manual handling steps within the process are required. Which instrument to choose depends really on the type of starting material that you have and the volumes that should be separated. And in addition to these instruments that can help you with cell separation, also for the flow analysis, the MaxQuant, the different types of the MaxQuant can be used for automated acquisition and data analysis. And here, with regards to this question, I also see one of the next questions that fits topically quite well. That is a question regarding the straight from microbeads. These microbeads work really well together with the Multimax. So for semi-automated fast isolation of your target cells directly from different starting materials. So the question is, how much faster is the isolation of either NK cells or T cells with the straight from kits? Yeah, and what I only want to highlight here is that as you can skip the density gradient centrifugation and directly incubate the blood sample with the microbeads, you can save a lot of time. And the kits can be used either for whole blood, BuffyCoat, Leukopak or LRC, and usually you then get your target cells within 30 minutes. Okay, then the next question is, do you need the patient's tumor cells for cell-mediated target cell killing?
Yeah, so I will answer this question. It's a very good question. So you don't necessarily need them. So you don't need the patient tumor cells, so primary cells. What you need is a target cell line that expresses the antigen, and it needs to be expressed on the cell surface, of course. This can be tumor cells isolated from patient tumors. If you decide to use such primary cell cultures, I would strongly recommend to prove the expression of your target antigen beforehand by flow cytometry. The easier way is, of course, always to use a cell line that stably expresses your antigen of interest to make the whole assay a bit more robust. So the next question, this goes to Julia again. Do you need both cytokines, IL-2 and IL-15, for superior NK cell expansion?
Yeah, thank you for this question. In general, also IL-2 alone in combination with our NK-MUX medium is sufficient to induce good NK cell expansion. However, when comparing both and adding IL-15 on top, it has even a slightly better expansion, especially as what is with regards to this important is that IL-15 has an anti-apoptotic effect. And also to mention here, NK cells are really picky, so they do not like to be cultured and expanded. So their growth usually starts only from day 7 on, so they really have like a starting hurdle, and as IL-15 is anti-apoptotic, it's really beneficial to include it. So the next question, after CAR T-cell engineering, there's still significant portion of untransduced T-cells. Do you have any product for selective isolation of transduced CAR T-cells over non-transduced CAR T-cells?
Yes, we do have a solution. I did not mention it in the presentation, but we do so. We developed our so-called CAR detection reagents, for example, the CD19 CAR detection reagent, and this has been developed to detect T cells that are engineered to express the CD19 CAR on their cell surface. And this, the binding of the reagent to the CAR T cells simulates in vivo binding of a CAR T cell to a tumor antigen. The reagent itself is biotinylated and can be detected via ferrochrome conjugated antibiotin antibodies. And yeah, another advantage is that our reagent comes ready to use with a mutated IgG1 Fc for minimal background staining. And moreover, as already pointed out for the RAAS, no FcR receptor blocking is needed. So now we have another question regarding our flow solutions. Are there different MuxPlex cytokine kits?
Yes, and here I'm going to answer again. There are different kits available. This is on the one hand the pre-mixed kits which include the MuxPlex cytokine 12 kit, so with 12 different cytokines, and also especially for the cytotoxic T and NK cells we have the MuxPlex cytotoxic T and NK cell kit, but also a more customized solution where you can pick and choose different analytes of interest and then analyze these together, for example TNF, interferon gamma, or IL-2, so whatever is of interest for you. So please check on our website. One more question I see here, this is, why do you not use a flow-based cell sorter to enrich for the T cells before activation?
Yeah, this question goes to me. So it's quite a good question. So of course you can go for a flow-based cell sorter to sort and enrich your T cells. You can also use magnetic isolation of your T cells. Both is possible. For the flow sorting, we also do offer the Max Quantito, and this is differs from a common droplet sorter as the cells are sorted within a closed cartridge system. However, it is a matter of time that is required. So the max. So if you go for a cell sorting, you need the machine. This is very usually it's a rather big machine, and you also need to have access to them. And then it can also take some time. You need to stain your cells beforehand, and yeah, you need this special instrument. And yes, you can do it easier and faster and under every bench in every lab if you decide for the magnetic enrichment. If it comes to very rare cell populations, for example, special T cell subsets or Tregs, then it might be useful and helpful to go for the enrichment by a flow sorter beforehand. I hope this does answer your question. The next question.
Yeah, the next question is that you were wondering whether our vectorfusine was tested only on T cells from healthy donors, or whether it was also tried on T cells isolated from cancer patients.
So, So the GMP version of vectorfusin is already used in clinical trials, and here sure we transduce patient-derived T cells in an autologous setting to generate CAR T cells. So the answer is yes, that this was tested and is possible.
And with this, thank you for all these questions. And all the questions that were not answered yet, please still submit them here, because they will get forwarded to Saskia and me, and then we can answer later via email. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Saskia and Julia. We would also like to thank LabRoots and our sponsor, Miltenyi Biotech, for underwriting today's educational webcast. Like our speakers mentioned, questions we did not have time for today and those submitted during the on-demand period will be addressed by our speakers via the contact information you provided at the time of registration. This webcast can be viewed on demand. LabRoots will alert you via email when it's available for replay. We encourage you to share that email with your colleagues who may have missed today's event. Until next time, take care. Goodbye.